What's up, investors? My name is Artem Dikrev, and in a couple of minutes you will know what are fixed assets. I'll first give you a professional definition and then I'll explain it as easy as I can with examples. And if you want to learn personal finances and investing watching such short videos, please consider subscribing to my channel and liking this video to show the support for the young creator. Many more videos are coming. Thanks so much, let's get straight to the point. Alright, so fixed assets are long-term tangible assets that a company uses in its operations to generate revenue. Fixed assets are a part of assets on a balance sheet, and if you're not sure what assets or balance sheet means, feel free to watch my previous videos. And here is an example. Fixed assets are basically capital assets. You don't just use and replace them every year like current assets. Fixed assets are your long-term properties. And the biggest representatives of fixed assets would be vehicles, machinery, equipment, and buildings. That is why, generally speaking, fixed assets appear on a balance sheet as property, plant, and equipment account. Fixed assets are those assets that help you generate revenue. For example, if you're a delivery company, your warehouse and your delivery trucks will be your fixed assets. Because you use the warehouse to store the goods and you use delivery trucks to make deliveries. In contrast, current assets help you to run your business operations as smooth as possible. For example, you use cash to purchase supplies, which are later used in the production of goods. And then these goods are stored as inventory, which can be later sold. Fixed assets are basically the machine of your business. And current assets are the fuel that make this machine work. Fixed assets can also be depreciated, which basically means is to distribute the value of an asset across its total lifespan. If you buy a brand new truck for $100,000, you will never be able to sell it 10 years later at the same price. For this reason, depreciation exists. It allows to depreciate the total cost of truck of $100,000 across 10 years, which basically means that every year your truck will lose $10,000 of its value. Money spent and received from buying and selling fixed assets goes under cash flows from investing, which can be found on cash flow statement. Because buying, for example, a factory is considered to be an investment in your business. And this is just one of the examples how financial statements can interact between each other. And if you still have any questions after watching this video, feel free to leave a comment and I'll personally reply to you. Check my other videos to see if there's anything else you want to learn about personal finances and investing. Thank you all so much for spending this couple of minutes with me. I really hope there was something new that you learned today that was straight to the point.